A capacitor can store energy, and a resistor placed in series with it will control the rate at which it charges or discharges. This produces a characteristic time dependence that turns out to be exponential. The crucial parameter that describes the time dependence is the time constant, also called tau, RC. For RC circuits, tau is simply equal to R times C. The simplest RC circuit is a capacitor and resistor in series. When a circuit consists of only a charged capacitor and a resistor, the capacitor will discharge its stored energy through the resistor. When a circuit consists of a power supply, a resistor, and an uncharged capacitor, the capacitor will charge based on the current flowing through the resistor. The resistor is often used to control the rate at which the capacitor charges and discharges. Time constants in RC circuits can sound intimidating, but the behavior is relatively simple when you think about it. With a higher resistance, the current in the circuit is decreased, and the capacitor charges more slowly. With a lower resistance, the current in the circuit is increased, and the capacitor charges more quickly. RC circuits can be used to filter a signal by blocking certain frequencies and passing others. The two most common RC filters are the high-pass filters and low-pass filters. A high-pass filter is a circuit that will pass signals with a frequency above a certain cutoff frequency and attenuate signals with a frequency below that cutoff. A low-pass filter will pass signals with a lower frequency than the cutoff and attenuate signals with a higher frequency than the cutoff. One common use for an RC circuit is the RC integrator. The integrator is a low-pass filter circuit that converts a square wave input signal into a triangular waveform output. And that if the time constant is long compared to the time period of the input RC waveform, then the resultant output will be triangular in shape. While the square wave is positive, the capacitor is charging, and the triangle wave is increasing. When the square wave goes negative, the capacitor starts to discharge, and the triangle wave starts decreasing. The higher the input frequency, the lower the output amplitude compared to that of the input, because the capacitor will have less time to charge. The differentiator is a high-pass filter circuit that can convert a square wave input into high-frequency spikes at its output. If the time constant is short compared to the time period of the input waveform, then the capacitor will become fully charged more quickly before the next change in the input cycle. When the capacitor is fully charged, the output voltage across the resistor is zero. The arrival of the falling edge of the input waveform causes the capacitor to reverse charge, giving a negative output spike. Then, as the square wave input charges during each cycle, the output spike changes from a positive value to a negative value. RC circuits are an important feature of filters in AC circuits. If we pass an AC voltage signal through an RC circuit, the shape of the waveform is unchanged, but its amplitude is affected. By changing the positions of the resistor or the capacitor, simple first-order low-pass or high-pass filters can be made. Low-pass filters will pass low-frequency signals from the input to the output with little or no reduction in signal or attenuation, while high-frequency signals will be reduced or attenuated significantly, almost to zero in some cases. Low-pass filters are often used as voltage spike protection circuits. High-pass filters work exactly opposite. High-frequency signals will pass from input to output with little or no reduction in signal, while low-frequency signals will be reduced significantly. These types of circuits are often used to block DC voltage from sensitive circuitry.